In today's video, we are going to explore ionic bonds. Now, the aim of all atoms is to become what we call stable. Stability for an atom comes from obtaining a complete outer shell of electrons. The only atoms of elements that have a full outer shell are in column 8 of our periodic table. These are our noble gases. All other atoms need to bond with other atoms in order to obtain this stability. One way in which atoms can do this is by forming an ionic bond. These bonds are formed between metal and non-metal atoms. Let me show you how this works with a couple of examples. Here we have a sodium atom and a chlorine atom. Sodium is number 11 on our periodic table. That means it has 11 electrons surrounding it. Now we know that our electrons are organized into the orbitals or into the shells in a particular pattern. And that is that there are 2 electrons in the first shell, 8 in the second, and we can have 8 in the third shell. Now, the arrangement of sodiums means that there is only 1 electron in the outermost shell of the atom. Now, let's have a look at chlorine. Chlorine is our nonmetal, and chlorine is number 17 on our periodic table. That means chlorine has 17 electrons. And the way that the electrons are arranged for chlorine means that there are 7 electrons in its outermost shell. Now, a question I'm often asked is, how do we know whether an atom is going to donate or accept electrons? Consider this. Look at sodium. Sodium has 1 electron in its outermost shell. Is it easiest for sodium to lose that 1 electron in order to move down a number of orbitals and therefore has a full outer shell? Or is it easier for sodium to try and gain 7 electrons? Hopefully you answered that it seems easier for sodium to be able to just donate 1 electron than it is for it to find 7 others. Now look at chlorine. Chlorine has 7 electrons in the outermost shell. Is it easiest for chlorine to accept 1 electron or to try and get rid of 7 electrons? Hopefully you answered it would be easiest for chlorine to just accept 1 electron than for it to try and find 7 places for its electrons. So sodium donates an electron to chlorine. When sodium donates an electron, it becomes slightly positive because it has less negatively charged particles than it did have. In the same way, chlorine becomes slightly more negative because now it has more negatively charged particles than it did have. Now we have 2 unlike charges, a positively charged atom and a negatively charged atom. And we know that opposite charges attract. There is an electrostatic pull between them. It is that pull that we name the ionic bond. Now, ionic bonds are actually very strong. They are stronger than covalent bonds and stronger than dispersion forces, and they will hold those 2 atoms close together. Let's have a look at another example. Here we have a beryllium atom. Beryllium is number 4 on our periodic table. It has 4 electrons, and that means it has 2 electrons in its outer shell. And let's look at fluorine. Fluorine is number 9 on our periodic table, and it has 9 electrons, and it has 7 of those in its outer shell. Now, beryllium wants to donate electrons, okay, and so it wants to give one to fluorine. Fluorine can accept 1 electron from the beryllium atom. But it can only accept 1. It only has space for 1. So, how then is beryllium going to get rid of both of its electrons? Well, all this means is that beryllium doesn't need 1 fluorine. It needs 2 fluorine atoms in order to get rid of both of those outer shell of electrons. Now, this is actually really helpful because it shows us where our formula comes from when we go to write the chemical formula for beryllium fluoride. It comes from here. 1 beryllium atom needs to give away 2 electrons, and in order to do that, it needs 2 fluorine atoms. And that means that the formula for beryllium fluoride is BeF2. I hope this video has helped to give you an introduction into ionic bonds and given you a base understanding of what they are and where they come from. If you like this video, please hit like and subscribe below for more videos from me.